Hey, what's up, everybody? Dornell Dana here, coming at you with another kick-ass episode of the Art of Mortgage Marketing podcast. And today we're going to talk about how to stop being the bottleneck in your business, how to stop being the chief cook and bottle washer, wearing all the hats, doing everything yourself, and having a glorified job trading time for money in the time for money treadmill instead of building a business that sets you free, how to get out from the office ball and chain, doing everything yourself, and get into freedom, get into liberty, get into doing what you do best and get the best to do all the rest. Because let's be real, you got in this business not to have a glorified job, not to trade time for money, not to be working 50, 60, 70 hours a week, evenings and weekends with an office ball and chain around your ankle going crazy. You got into this business because you wanted freedom. You wanted lifestyle. You wanted to make a massive impact. You wanted to help a lot of people, and you wanted to do it with a whole lot more fun and fulfillment and freedom. True? So if indeed that is the case, we've got to engineer your business to do that. Because far too often, I see well-intended, well-meaning mortgage professionals who've been in this business for a few years or a few decades, and days turn into weeks, weeks turn into months. They've got all the best of intentions, but they never sit down and actually get clarity on what they need to do daily to get to their income goal and their lifestyle goal and their freedom goal. And so what happens is they end up touting great rates, great service, and I'm available evenings and weekends because everyone else is touting that. So I better follow suit and do that too, because heaven forbid I do something different. Heaven forbid I don't offer to be able to show up at their house on weekends or to answer their phone call anytime they damn well feel like having help from me. Heaven forbid I not be available and people hit voicemail. Heaven forbid, because people realize very early in the game that if they don't have unique value, they're going to lose business. But they don't realize that there's a lot of different ways to add unique value than to be towed around by the electronic leash called your smartphone and to be available 24/7. Let me ask you this. When's the last time you saw an absolute expert in their field, whether it be a specialist surgeon or a specialist in any walk of life who's available 24/7? When's the last time you heard of a specialist doctor or a specialist lawyer or a specialist in any professional background who is available anytime you damn well feel like calling them? Chances are never. Why? Because that's what generalists do. Specialists don't do that. Specialists call their own shots. Specialists call their own terms. Specialists determine how they want their life to be, and then they engineer it accordingly. They're not available evenings and weekends. They're not available anytime someone wants them. They're not available based on anyone's whim or wish. They're available based on the way they want to be available, their office schedule. And people line up and wait and are on a waiting list to work with those people. Why? Because they offer unique value no one else offers. They're irreplaceable and indispensable, and they're the bomb freaking diggity, and everyone knows it. That's why they wait in line. That's why they get in the queue on the waiting list, because this person is an expert. They're world class at what they do, and they're not easily replaceable, such that they can call their own shots, their own terms, and everyone else has to follow suit. And that's my goal for you guys, is that you get out of being a generalist, a replaceable commodity, a replaceable cog in the proverbial wheel, and get into being an expert who calls your own shots. If you want to have your weekends off, you can have that. If you want to work Monday to Friday, 30 to 40 hours a week, making $500,000 plus per year, you can have that. If you have the right leverage, the right systems, the right kick-ass, compelling, unique value proposition, such that people can't replace you because the value you deliver is so exquisite and so potent and so powerful. But you can't just hope and wish and pray you're going to have that. You need to be able to have that in place before you can call your own shots. But Doran, don't you call your own shots first and then people will follow? Yeah, if you're replaceable, if you're not replaceable if you set yourself up so you're irreplaceable. The problem is most mortgage professionals, they're not irreplaceable. They're just hawking mortgages. They're hawking the same mortgages and the same rates and terms as everyone else. They got the same logo. They got the same slogan. They got the same products, the same services, and the same rates. No wonder they're offering to be available anytime the client wants them. No wonder they're driving 15, 20, 30 miles to meet a client at their home because they think, hey, I offer the same as anyone else, so I'm going to inconvenience myself and my family and have no freaking life to meet these people at their homes because otherwise, why would they work with me? I got the same rates, the same service, the same programs and products. So why else would they work for me or work with me rather? And that's what gets you being the bottleneck in your business is you have this erroneous assumption and presumption that the only unique value you can offer is driving across town, battling through traffic and meeting people at coffee shops or in their homes. That ain't the only option. The only option is not to be available evenings and weekends. There are other options available. And your goal should be to stretch yourself out of your comfort zone to equip yourself with so much kick-ass value that you don't have to sacrifice evenings and weekends. You can put your phone away. You can go on vacation and leave your phone in the resort apartment suite and never have to look at it because you got your business running like a finely oiled machine in your absence. Or you can be present for your spouse. You can be present for your kids. You can literally leave your phone locked up and not have to look at it all day. And your revenue keeps flowing. Your business keeps growing. It's running like a finely oiled machine in your absence. And you're stepping into true freedom. And I know that's what you want. I know that's what everyone wants. Everyone wants to be a champion. But not everyone's willing to pay the price to become a champion. Because truth be told, there's a lot of gravitational pulls that pull us away from having that freedom and being our own bottleneck and getting in our own way. One of them is having that mantra that if I want it done right, I gotta do it my what? Do it myself. Sound familiar? So some of you are control freaks and I get it. I'm there too. I want everything done right. I want excellence for excellence sake. And I don't want some monkey messing up with my program and messing up my reputation and messing up the relationships that I have with my clients and my partners. I get it. So there's good reason to have iron-fisted control. And there's good reason to be a control freak because you want excellence. The problem is usually we don't just have an erroneous belief about having to do it all ourselves. We also have a belief that good people are hard to find. So these negative Nelly type of belief systems, these limiting belief systems usually come in pairs. They usually come with cousins and siblings. And so they're usually not on their own. They usually come with a multitude of other limiting beliefs. So the first belief is, if I want it done right, I got to do it myself. The second limiting belief is, it's hard to find good people. Notice how those are conjoined. Notice how those are brother and sister limiting beliefs. They work together in tandem. And they keep you trapped. They keep you being the chief cook and bottle washer, wearing all the hats and being your own bottleneck, your own worst enemy, running on the treadmill, wearing all the hats, doing everything yourself and having no freaking life. And until and unless you get connected to how much it sucks, having a glorified job, trading time for money and not having a life and being glued to your smartphone 24/7, not being present for those you love most, not being able to actually have true freedom because you don't have a real business, you have a glorified job, you have a practice. Until and unless you get heart connected, which that sucks, you're never gonna change it, right? You're gonna soften the problem. You're gonna say things like, but Dorn, I'm making great money. I'm making better than most. I'm in the top 1% of income earners or the top 10% of income earners. I'm not doing so bad. It's kind of like the fat guy who says, I'm not fat, I'm just big boned. No, you're freaking fat. And until and unless you get heart connected to how much it sucks being fat, you're never gonna do what it takes to fix it. Same thing here. You gotta get heart connected to how much it sucks being your own bottleneck. Because truth be told, where you are weak, someone else is unique. Someone else has cracked the code. Someone else is dancing in their strengths in that area. So where you are weak, someone else is unique. You don't have to have it all figured out. You don't have to be a genius in all areas. You don't have to have every single area of your business your zone of genius. You can just do what you do best and get the best of all the rest, but not if you think, you know, it's hard to find top talent, or not if you think that good people are hard to find, or not if you think that if you want it done right, you got to do it all yourself. Screw freaking that. If you don't want it done right, you need to have a top talent team. If you want it done right, you need to attract superstars and cultivate a team of superstars, superstars only. And truth be told, if someone else can do it 80% as well as you, then delegate it, because now you can get more done. You can serve more clients. Would you rather have 100% of 5 loans a month, or would you rather have 10% of 50 loans a month? If you have a top talent team that manages all the minutia, so you're not pulling your hair out and putting out fires all day, you got to be knowing you'd rather have the 50 loans a month, because that gives you freedom. You don't have to be there. You can be rocking it out in your Bahamas in the pajamas, and to be have a life of freedom and autonomy and independence, calling your own shots, doing your own thing. If you want to work, you can work. If you don't want to work, you don't have to work. You can work 15, 20, 25 hours a week if you want. Once you have the people in place, the systems in place, the policy, procedure, protocol in place. But you're never going to get there. You're never going to create that business that sets you free if you think that if I want it done right, I got to do it myself. Good people are hard to find. Screw that. They're hard to find because you believe they're hard to find. Sure, there may be, you know, 1 in 1,000 or 1 in 10,000 or 1 in 50,000. You may be chasing unicorns, but what if you are a unicorn magnet? What if that was your identity? What if you're a superstar magnet? What if you attract top talent people all day, every day, because that's just who you are, because you have that belief and you prove yourself right? What if that's the belief that you manifest? What's that? What if that's the evidence you collect? Because as good old Henry Ford once said, whether you believe you can or you can't, you're right. So there are belief systems that allow you to create freedom, and there are belief systems that keep you enslaved. Those are two of those beliefs that you've got to eradicate from your mental factory. Remove from your garden. Pull those weeds out from your garden, the garden of your mind, if you want to create freedom. And then replace them with the seeds of truth, that you attract superstars and you will only accept superstars and nothing less than superstars on your team. And that you attract the best people on your team. You do what you do best, you get the best to do all the rest. Teamwork makes the dream work. It may sound cliche, may sound trite, but it's true. Teamwork makes the dream work. And if you want to create an epic business and an epic life, you need to have an epic team. And that starts with you. Water seeks its own level. If you're operating at a 5 out of 10, you're going to attract fives, because truth be told, your people are going to do double what you do wrong and half of what you do right. You know it and I know it, because if you've ever tried to build a team, you know that to be true. They're going to do double what you do wrong and half of what you do right. So the best way to build a winning team is you step up into your winner self, be the best version of yourself, and to become that winner you want to attract. Because eagles like to soar with eagles. They don't like to scratch in the chicken yard with the chickens. They want to soar with eagles. Are you showing up as the eagle that you know you're called to be? Are you investing yourself to become the eagle mortgage professional you are called to be? Are you trying to reinvent the wheel, doing it the hard way? And that leads to the third belief that holds you back from freedom, that keeps you being stuck as a bottleneck. And it's actually fresh on my mind because I just did a call with a client earlier today. She's on track doing about 40K net after taxes. She's been in the game 40 years. She's beautiful. She's brilliant. She's got an amazing, pleasing personality. She brings amazing value to the marketplace. She's got great expertise. She's got everything going for her. She even joined a new company. So she's got great options, great rates. Everything is there, but she's on track to make 40K net after taxes this year, after sliding down the mountain and just kissing the underside of 100K last year, which is her best year, way underperforming what she's capable of because she's got this belief, this identity that she's cheap. I'm cheap. She told me that at least 3 times. I'm cheap. Now it's fine to be prudent. It's fine to be frugal in areas that you need to be frugal. There's nothing wrong with that. But if you see yourself as being cheap as your identity, it's going to hold you back from making a bold intelligent, strategic investment in your breakthrough. Because what happens is you end up trying to cobble together a shoestring budget plan. You say, I'm cheap, so I'm going to watch some free videos on YouTube. I'm going to read some free articles on some blogs. I'm going to cobble together some makeshift formula. And then you wonder why it ain't working. Well, wonder no longer. If you're trying to reinvent the wheel, it ain't going to go so well. I mean, if you try and build the hole for the foundation for the skyscraper with a gardening trowel because you're being cheap, that ain't going to go so well. You're going to be cheap, but you're going to have a very expensive impact on your life. Being cheap is expensive. It's the most expensive thing you can do because now you're wasting time. This lady was spending literally 65, 70 hours a week grinding to make 40K net a year. That's freaking expensive. Leaving a shit ton of money on the table every single week grinding because she's seeing herself as cheap and she's not willing to invest in the solution. And so week after week after week, she's wasting all this time, banging her head against the wall, going nowhere. Realtors not giving her the time of day. Realtors being apathetic and arrogant, sloughing her off because she's got no unique value. She doesn't know how to approach them. She doesn't know how to have a compelling kick-ass offer. So she's doing the same thing as everyone else and getting the same old results, which is jack, diddly, squat, nada. That's expensive. It's called the tuition of not knowing. Not knowing how to attract top producing realtors like a hot knife through butter. Not knowing how to become irreplaceable and indispensable. Not knowing how to add so much value that you get to call your own shots and dictate your own terms. Not knowing how to mine the gold from your database and maximize repeat and referral business. Not knowing how to use technology to systematize and streamline and automate your business so it sets you free. And what you're left with is slavery. You're left with slavery, grinding, sleepless nights, stress, perturbance and disturbance, frustration, pain, real pain. Because when you know you're an eagle, you know you're called to be an eagle, and you're scratching around in the chicken yard with the chickens, there's something about that that just corrodes your joy every day. It just erodes your peace of mind every day. It sucks the life out of your passion and your fulfillment every day. That's a special kind of suck. I don't know about you, but I know that in my heart, I'm designed to soar. I'm designed to live a life of freedom, passion, impact, contribution. Chances are you feel the same way. And when you're slugging through the mud with concrete blocks on your feet doing it the hard way, that hurts. That hurts. And your mind's constantly trying to figure out the puzzle, right? Trying to figure out, how do I get this fixed? Because you're sick and tired of worrying where your next deal is going to come from. And you realize there's just so many moving parts to this thing, right? There's your email marketing. There's your database marketing. There's your social media marketing. There's advertising on Google AdWords and Facebook and YouTube and Instagram and everything else. And then there's how to get these realtors on board and what unique value to deliver to them. And there's how to create videos that sell and that cultivate those relationships and maximize repeat and referral business. And there's how to get on Google with 5-star reviews so you become the only logical choice. And there's how to actually deliver real value to your partners in terms of helping them mine the gold from their database and helping them, you know, turn their dead leads into hot for what you've got leads and all these things that they need and what they want. And then there's just all the technology that undergirds all this crap. It's enough to make your head spin just thinking about it, is it not? The bad news is, if you wanna make $500,000 plus per year, you need to figure out how to do this stuff. The good news is you don't have to figure it out yourself, because where you are weak, other people are unique. The whole goal of making bold, intelligent, strategic investments in your business when it comes to marketing, and the whole goal of having a kick-ass top talent team, is to remove you as the bottleneck. So you don't have to reinvent the wheel anymore. You don't have to be the chief cook and bottle washer anymore. You don't have to do it yourself anymore. The whole goal of having a kick-ass team and having the best of the best in your corner is to liberate you so you can do what you do best and get the best to do all the rest. That's the whole point, friends. But if you think you're too cheap and it's too costly to get a proven plan, you have not gotten present. You have not gotten real with yourself with how many countless hours you've wasted banging your head against the wall doing it the hard way. You have not gotten present to how much money you're leaving on the table every single month to your competitors, because you don't know what you don't know. You have not gotten present to the fact that you can't get that time back that you wasted, spinning your wheels, not getting the outcome, fruitless toil. You have not counted the cost of the sleepless nights, of the adventures you haven't had or didn't have, of the trips you didn't have, of the contributions to meaningful causes you couldn't make because you're in survival mode, just getting by, just skating by in survival mode. Once you get present to how much that freaking sucks to be in survival mode, just be surviving instead of thriving, giving up all that money, leaving that money on the table to your competitors, watching other people win instead of you winning, watching other people live your dream, you just get to the point where you just decide enough is a freaking enough. I've had it no more. I'm done with this. I'm ready to rise up. I'm ready to win. Once you get to that point, that's when you're ready for your breakthrough. And that's what it takes to get out from being your own bottleneck, is to have that defiant resolve in your heart where you just decide enough is enough, no more. I'm done with being John Wayne, trying to be John Wayne and be the strong guy or the strong gal, try to do everything myself. It's lonely. It's tiresome. It's exhausting. And it's fruitless toil. It's trying to do everything yourself is not only lonely and tiresome and exhausting, it doesn't get you to the freedom you want. It doesn't get you spreading your wings and soaring like you want. It doesn't get you having the fun and the fulfillment that you want. So we got to get out of our own way. And I'll tell you what, I've been there too. I've been there where I'm like, why am I doing this? I should be delegating this. Why am I doing this menial task that's draining me? I got a headache just thinking about it. Why am I not delegating this task? I'm banging my head against the wall doing this task month after month after month. Why don't I just delegate it? It's like this novel concept, right? It's because we're trained by society, school. Don't cheat. Don't look at other people's work. Don't work as a team. You got to do it all yourself. Look at your own work. Stay focused on your own work. You know, do your own thing. Mind your own business, right? So we're trained by society ever since we're knee-high to a grasshopper to just be these little mini John Waynes and pulling up our proverbial big boy or big girl pants and doing it all ourselves. That's a recipe for punching a clock, trading time for money in the time for money treadmill with an office ball and chain around our ankle and a glass ceiling over our head, trudging through the muck with concrete blocks on our feet and just being this 9-to-5 prison. If you want to be a 9-to-5 prison, that works great because you have your responsibilities, you have your tasks, just do it, right? But as an entrepreneur, as a solopreneur, as someone who writes your own ticket on 100% commission, that model of the world doesn't work. That model of the world keeps you stuck, keeps you lost, keeps you suffering in stagnation, regression, and ultimately living a life of regret, settling for a second best life of regret, because you know you're capable of more. You see other people kicking ass. Why not you? And then you beat yourself up. Why can't I figure this out? Why is this taking me so long? Why is this so hard? Why are other people winning and I'm not? And ultimately you look at yourself in the mirror and you're not measuring up because you demand more of yourself. And you know you're not even scratching the surface of the surface of your capacity and your capability and your calling and your potential. So if you've come to the place where you're just like, enough is enough, no more, I've had it, I'm done with being the chief cook and bottle washer, I'm done with wearing all the hats, I'm done with doing it all myself, I'm done with being the bottleneck in my life and my business, I invite you to take advantage of a complimentary breakthrough call with either me or one of my consultants, where we lift up the hood on your business, we look at what's working, what's not working, where you're at now, where you want to be. And if we help you create a breakthrough in your business, by all means, we will show you how. We'll show you how to do that with a proven formula and a proven plan with a proven recipe. And if not, we'll be the first people to advise you to pass on our services. Either way, our goal for you is that you leave the call with massive clarity, clarity like you've never had before, on what it really takes to create your breakthrough. But this breakthrough call is only for those who are defiantly committed to making at least an extra 100K in the next 12 months above and beyond what you're already doing without working any harder, just working smarter, not putting in more hours, just getting more from the hours you're already putting in. So if that's you and you're on 100% commission, you earn 80 basis points or more in your comp plan and you're defiantly committed to kicking ass, and making at least an extra 100K or more per year, working smarter, not harder, having a whole lot more fun and fulfillment along the way, I invite you to book this breakthrough call with either me or one of my consultants. Go ahead and do that now at mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. We'll have a honest conversation. We'll look at what's going on in your life and your business in terms of where you're at now and where you want to be. And if we can help you bridge that gap and cause you to go stratospheric and pour gasoline on the fire, we'll show you how to do it. And believe it or not, it's a lot more simple than you might think. It doesn't have to be complicated. It doesn't have to be, you know, super crazy multiple steps. It doesn't have to be banging your head against the wall doing cold calling. It doesn't have to be doing fancy funnels. It doesn't have to be doing all that marketing crap you don't want to be doing. It's just elegant simplicity with what works. No need for doing it the hard way. There's no brownie points at the bank for doing it the hard way. No need to spend more time, more energy, more money than you need to. I'm all about the shortest path to the cash. There's no merit badges at the bank for doing it the hard way. So if you're in alignment with that, if you're picking up what I'm putting down, let's talk. Let's see what we can do to help you. I mean, if your way ain't working at the level you need it to, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Let's talk. Let's show you how to take it to the next level. We are experts in our field. We've been doing this for 15 years. This is not our first rodeo. So if you're done with trying to reinvent the wheel and you want the best in your corner to help you and show you the pathway to breakthrough, let's talk. MortgageMarketingCoach.com/apply. So again, my name is Doran Aldana. We've been talking today about how to stop being the bottleneck in your business. I trust you got some distinctions, some healthy reminders. We often need reminding more than we need educating. So you're welcome. I'm here for you. And I hope that you've gotten at least one key distinction, or maybe you just got the kick in the ass you need to say enough is enough. I'm reaching out to Doran. I'm going to see what he can do to help me. If indeed you got one key thing from this, that's my goal for you. So this is the Art of Mortgage Marketing podcast. Doran Aldana hanging with you for another episode. And we'll be back again for another kick-ass episode in the near future next week. So be blessed. Love you guys. Go forth. Take massive action. Bring massive positivity to that action. Chances are you're going to get massive results. Talk to you soon, y'all. Peace.